Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. I am Dr. Aram Sadiq and working as assistant professor at the Department of Psychiatry and Behavioral Sciences, Faisalabad Medical University. Today I will discuss with you people about informational care. This lecture is for third year MBBS and second year BDS and from the book of Behavioral Sciences. So students, today we will discuss what is informational care and how you can provide informational care technically to your patients. Whenever a patient came to you with certain illnesses, they have multiple questions in their mind, like what they are suffering from, what kind of treatment is provided, what will illness do with them. So try to ask these questions and answer them in a very simple and technical language but understandable to the patients. So basically, informational care is non-pharmacological intervention in which you have to give a technical information, understandable language to the patient about their illness, and please keeping in mind about the socio-cultural background of the patient also. You can give them examples from their profession, from their culture to explain the illness. So basically, informational care is defined as the provision of information to the patient using principles of communication regarding the disease, the drug, and the doctor that concern him or her. So this is to help fill the gap in the patient's knowledge and understanding in these areas using the language that the patient understands. If you talk with the patient in Urdu and your patient talk to you with Punjabi, so switch your language from Urdu to Punjabi. You can ask the patient either he wanted to talk in English, in Urdu, in Punjabi, or whatever patient wants. Then convert your technical terms into the language which patient can understand. So during ill health, the patient as well as the concerns others feel a desperate need to know what is exactly wrong, how it is being or will be managed, who all will deliver the care and how. So the amount of information provided, timings, language, and setting in which informational care is imparted has to be tailored according to the individual needs of the patient, the stage of the illness or recovery, and the question that bother the patient the most. You all people will have medical knowledge about the illnesses. You know about all the terms, you know about all kind of the treatment, but you have to tailor that information according to your patient. For example, you know, the most common illness nowadays is diabetes. Let's talk about diabetes. You know all the things about diabetes. You know all the etiology. You know all the kind of treatment, recent advances. But what, in which stage your patient is with you and which information you have to give to the patient, it should be tailored into your mind. Do not give a lot of information. Do not bombard the technical terms on the patient which he or she cannot understand. So try to be simpler, and please do not also hide the prognosis. If there is something worse like cancer, like in other diseases, clear the patient, give them hope, but clear the patient about the prognosis of the disease. So you have to answer the questions into patient's language, very important. Timings, again, it is very important, and tailored according to the individual needs, the in which stage your patient is and what kind of treatment you have to give on, and what psychosocial management plan you have for your patient. So tailor them according to the needs of the patient. So basically, IC session included 7 questions which are given into your books of behavioral sciences. All patients keep in mind that all patients have these certain questions, so you have to answer them one by one. The need for informational care is this, that nowadays you are seeing that there are conflict arising between doctors and attendant and the patient. Some patient attendant beat the doctor, And there are many events you have seen, I think, from the last many times. The reason for this is on the half of doctors also and on the half of patients. On the half of doctor is this, we are so much busy in our OPDs, in our emergencies, in our wards, that we are unable to provide proper information regarding the illness to the patients and their attendants. It doesn't take a lot of time, it doesn't take hours to explain them about their illness. If you have tailored the information into your mind, about the patient into your mind, you can clearly tell the attendants about the illness. If you will clearly give them message, what is wrong with the patient and what is its prognosis, what is the kind of treatment you are giving, I think patients, attendant will get enough and they will not ask you repeatedly. So play your role properly in this all kind of patient care. So now we will discuss these 7 questions one by one. So what first question is, what is wrong with me? Here you have to tell the patient about the diagnosis. Most of the diagnoses which are in English are translated into Urdu as well. You can see them from different books and from different references. And this Urdu is technically understandable to the patient. Like for diabetes. Like for depression, there is Udasi and Afsurdagi. So there are these terms have Urdu also. So you will not confuse. So don't confuse them. And again, I will tell you that whatever the diagnosis of the patient, tell them in English also and tell them in Urdu as well. Why have I developed this disease? So here you have to tell the etiology. And keeping in mind, please see that you don't discuss the tables of Davidson to the patient or etiology tables, all what's written in your books to the patient. Tell them the etiology which is concerned with your that one patient. Like if you can divide the etiology into biopsychosocial model, then it will be easily you will explain them to the patient. So etiology, causes, what is the reason behind this illness? Tell them according to the need of that patient. Don't overload the information. The third question, is there any effective treatment to my problem, or is the treatment is safe, or are there any serious or dangerous side effects? So again, what treatment modality you are using? Either you are giving treatment in the form of tablets, you are giving treatment in the form of injectables, or you are doing any procedure or any kind of surgery for the illness of the patient. So tell them the whole treatment, what will you give them now, and for how long you are taking the treatment, the safety of the treatment, tolerability, and about side effects. Tell them the side effects which usually your patient faces. Like in our specialty, like depression, many antidepressants, patients feel dry mouth, constipation, and the common side effects of the drugs. So explain them these common side effects of the drugs. Yes, if there is any kind of serious side effects, like with the carbamazepine, the drug of antiepileptics, one of the drug of antiepileptic, there are some skin allergies. So anxious your patient with these kind of side effects, like if they get any skin allergy or if they can any itching on their skin, they can come to you and change the medication. Don't tell the most dangerous or the most rare side effects to your patient. They will not take medication after hearing all kind of the side effects of the medication. The next question is, how long will I take to recover? And this is again the prognosis, about prognosis of the disease. Please here, do not hide the seriousness of the illness, because if you will hide, the patient will not take medication properly, he will not take the follow-ups properly. So in case of severe diseases like cancer, kindly tell them what is the prognosis. And again, when you are talking about the prognosis, ask the patient about the profession he or she is, You can give them examples from their profession. Like if a farmer came to you and he is very, like in our villages, you can give them the example of their farms. Like you can tell them that not every seed produces the plant. Like some of our patients which don't respond to the first kind of medication, we give them the trial of other medications also. And which many diseases, they have different prognosis. Like some diseases have 1/3 patient who are not properly, 1/3 patients usually are not completely recovered. There are examples. So you can give them these kind of examples about the prognosis. And a very important question of IC, is there a Parhez restriction? Like in our society, it is very common to ask the patient, Doctor Saab, khane peene mein kya Parhez hai? So please, dietary restriction wahan karein jahan iski zarurat hai, like diabetes, like hypertension, like such kind of illnesses, jahan pe meethe se aapne Parhez karwana hai, aapne oily cheezon se karwana hai, but don't restrict them as usually. आप अगर अपनी सोसाइटी में देखें, हमारी सोसाइटी के लोग कोई बहुत ज्यादा न्यूट्रिशियस चीजें ऑलरेडी नहीं ले रहे. What they do, they leave all the such nutritious diets like eggs, like meat, and these all things, they said these are garam things and they will not take them with in their illness, and not they will not take their them with their medication. हमारी सोसाइटी में गर्म ठंडे का जो कॉन्सेप्ट है, उसकी वजह से लोग डाइट की बहुत सारी चीजों को रिस्ट्रिक्ट खुद से कर लेते हैं. सो प्लीज क्लियर देम कि जो मर्जी, जितना मर्जी अपनी सेहत के लिए खाएं, कोई खास परहेज नहीं है. जिन इलनेसेस में कोई डाइटरी परहेज नहीं है, यू कैन ऑल्सो आस्क देम कि आप ऑलरेडी क्या क्या परहेज कर रहे हैं. दे विल टेल यू, अंडा नहीं खा रहे हम, गोश्त नहीं खाते, वो गर्म होता है दवाई के साथ, दवाइयां भी गर्म होती हैं, खजूर नहीं खानी, दूध नहीं पीना, ये चीजें गर्म है तो ये इफेक्ट करेंगी हमें इसके साथ. तो वहां पे आप प्लीज इनको क्लियर करें. और अगर कोई परहेज बनता है टेक्निकली तो उनको गाइड करें, अदरवाइज उनको एजुकेट करें कि टेक प्रॉपर मील, बिकॉज अ बैलेंस्ड डाइट एंड अ प्रॉपर मील इज इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर एनी काइंड ऑफ रिकवरी ऑफ द इलनेस. एंड द अदर इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन इज, देयर आर रिस्क ऑफ इलनेस बीइंग स्प्रेड टू दोज अराउंड मी और पासिंग इट ऑन टू माय ऑफस्प्रिंग. Yes, again, this is very much important. People sometimes fear that they will pass their illness to their family members. Yes, there are many illnesses which are contagious, like nowadays due to coronavirus, which is very much contagious. In kind of contagious diseases, guide them properly how they can prevent this, they can prevent it spread. And like other diseases which have genetic causes, kindly guide them properly. Our next question is, how will the illness and treatment affect or influence my functioning? Can I continue to work or rest? What will happen to my sex life, sleep and appetite? This is very much important question to answer. Hamari society mein usually kya hota hai ke a patient is suffering from any kind of illness, they just took bed rest and continue that rest for long. आप एक दफा बेड रेस्ट लिख देते हैं, पेशेंट उसको वीक्स के ऊपर कंटिन्यू रखते हैं. सो प्लीज गाइड देम कितना उनको रेस्ट चाहिए, आइदर दे नीड इट और नॉट. इफ नॉट देन क्लियर देम टू डू योर नॉर्मल फंक्शनिंग. जितना नॉर्मल लाइफ आप उनको कर सकते हैं ड्यूरिंग इलनेस, इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. अदरवाइज दे कैन ऑप्ट सिक रोल, और वो फैमिली में ट्रीटमेंट के बाद भी इवन दे ऑप्टेड दैट सिक रोल एंड दे आर कंटिन्यू दैट सिक रोल ऑनवर्ड्स. तो बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है कि आपने उनकी नॉर्मल फंक्शनिंग में, ये डॉक्टर्स की ही जिम्मेदारी है कि आप उनको जैसे जैसे ट्रीटमेंट दे रहे हैं, जैसे पेशेंट आपका बेहतर हो रहा है, कीपिंग देम इन टू नॉर्मल लाइफ, उनको नॉर्मल लाइफ में लाना बहुत जरूरी है. अदरवाइज इलनेस तो खत्म हो जाएगी लेकिन सिक रोल खत्म नहीं होगा. व्हाट इलनेस और ट्रीटमेंट विल डू विद देयर स्लीप, विद देयर एपेटाइट, विद देयर सेक्सुअल लाइफ, एक्सप्लेन देम क्लियरली. इफ पेशेंट डिडंट आस्क यू, यू कैन आस्क देम कि व्हाट यू आर थिंकिंग दैट दीज थिंग्स विल डू विद योर रूटीन लाइफ और कीप देम देयर फंक्शनिंग नॉर्मल एज सून एज पॉसिबल. So these are seven essential questions for informational care. The physician must set aside certain time within a consultation to give a reasonable level of information to the patient and his family about the disease and treatment. बहुत सारे लोग ये कंप्लेन करते हैं डॉक्टर्स की, हम एक अटेंडेंट को, पेशेंट्स के अटेंडेंट्स चेंज होते रहते हैं, हम एक दफा इंफॉर्मेशनल केयर देते हैं देन एक दूसरा अटेंडेंट आ जाता है एंड दे आस्क क्या है कि हमारे मरीज के साथ क्या मसला है. तो यहाँ पे एक इम्पॉर्टेंट बात यह है कि जब आप डायग्नोसिस कर लेते हैं, आप एक ट्रीटमेंट प्लान आपके माइंड में बन जाता है, तो आप पेशेंट को फर्स्ट इन्फॉर्मेशन राइट इज टू द पेशेंट एंड सेकेंड यू कैन आस्क द पेशेंट कि विच डोमिनेंट अटेंडेंट योर पेशेंट लाइक्स फॉर द इन्फॉर्मेशन. आप उसी से आइडेंटिफाई करवाएं और एक डोमिनेंट सा कोई फैमिली में पर्सन होता है जिसका इन्फ्लुएंस होता है, आप उसको इन्फॉर्मेशनल केयर साथ में दें एंड जस्ट ये आपकी ड्यूटी है. बाकी आप उनसे कह सकते हैं कि अगर अटेंडेंट चेंज होते हैं यू कैन से देम कि हम इनकी बीमारी के बारे में दे चुके हैं, आप उनसे बातचीत करें. ठीक है. अच्छा जी, द इन्फॉर्मेशनल केयर सेशन मस्ट टेक प्लेस इन द लैंग्वेज दैट द पेशेंट कैन अंडरस्टैंड. It must start with patient's knowledge, understanding, and expectations. Always start informational care by asking patient what is in his mind about his illness. बहुत simple question आप यहाँ पे कर सकते हैं कि जैसे कि मैंने कुछ test करवाए हैं, मैंने आपकी अभी तक जितनी investigations करवाई हैं और हमने अभी तक जितना session किया है, आपको क्या लगता है आप किस बीमारी से गुजर रहे हैं? और उसमें पेशेंट के माइंड में जो होता है, जो मिथ्स होते हैं, जो मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग्स होती हैं, वो आपको बता देता है कि मुझे तो लगता है डॉक्टर साहब मेरा ये मसला है, और उसके साथ रिलेटेड जो जो उसकी इन्फॉर्मेशन होती है वो आपको बता देते हैं. तो इट वुड इजी फॉर यू कि आपने किन मिथ्स को क्लियर करना है, किस कितनी इन्फॉर्मेशन इम्पार्ट करनी है. तो काइंडली ऑलवेज स्टार्ट विद द पेशेंट्स नॉलेज, अंडरस्टैंडिंग एंड एक्सपेक्टेशन. The doctor must then remove any myths and misconceptions that the patient mentions in his description. These misconceptions must be immediately replaced with scientific basis and evidence base. आपने वो बात करनी है जो scientifically proven हो. You can use your paper and make the sketches for their understanding. जो भी वे आपको अच्छा लगता है आप अपने prescription के back side पर draw कर सकते हैं, उनको explain कर सकते हैं. और एविडेंस बेस्ड बात करनी है कि साइंसी तहकीक के मुताबिक या हमारी जो बुक किताबें हैं या हमने जो अभी तक तहकीकात पढ़ी हैं उनके मुताबिक इस बीमारी का इतना फीसद इलाज मुमकिन है या इस बीमारी के इतने फीसद लोग ठीक हो जाते हैं. आप इस किस्म की लैंग्वेज को यूज कर सकते हैं और अगर उनके कोई ऐसे मिसकंसेप्शन है उनको आप क्लियर कर सकते हैं. द टास्क ऑफ गिविंग इन्फॉर्मेशन शुड बी प्रोफेशनलाइज्ड. Meaning hereby that evidence-based facts are provided without fear of causing a negative reaction in patient or the relatives. आपकी informational care इतनी negative ना हो जाए कि patient or attendant treatment से ही भाग जाए. So this is important कि आपने कितनी information देनी है, उनको overload नहीं करना. Both aspects of the disease and treatment, negative and positive, should be communicated to the patient, but information overload is to be avoided. Again, use of simple figures, diagrams, sketches are often very helpful to enhance the patient's understanding. Most patients or relatives may like to keep the sketches at the end of the session, which consolidates the interest and utility of the informational care exercise in the therapeutic process. The informational care session ends with the patient briefly summarizing his new understanding of 3D, which are doctor, diagnosis and drugs. So initially, you can assess the misunderstandings about this 3D and later your patient will have new understanding about his illness. This helps to evaluate how much of the information has been retained. The doctor finally reassured that any future concerns and clarifications that are needed will also be addressed. So this is all about informational care. Hope you like the lecture. If you like, please don't forget to share and subscribe the channel. Thank you.